I'd like to begin by welcoming everyone and thanking each of you for being here to celebrate the marriage of Juliana Disher and Sean Branningham as they begin their new chapter together. Each of you represents someone important in the lives of Juliana and Sean, and they are so grateful that you have made the journey to be here today. I've been fortunate enough to meet many of you, but for those lucky few who have avoided me, my name is Derek. I am grateful to have known Juliana for 6 years now, and Sean a little while longer. It is tough to have a bad day around these two, as they always find a way to cheer you up or cheer you on. Their love has been a testament to what kind and goofy hearts can accomplish when paired together. I find that my words often fail me and fall short when reaching for sincerity, so I'll just say that it is my greatest honor. Moving on. Sean and Juliana's story began in the summer of 2018, where they spent weeks together at YMCA Camp Kern. While Juliana taught leadership skills, Sean taught the real life lessons by showing campers the joy of mudsliding and shucking corn. They shared many treasured memories as they grew closer throughout that summer. After camp concluded, Sean and Juliana found themselves back at the Ohio State University, go Bucks, where they made things official. We will now have Anna Lovelace, one of Juliana's closest college friends, read the poem "I'll Be There" by Louise Fidel.
I'll be there, my love, through thick and through thin. When your mind is a mess, when your head's in a spin, when your plane's been delayed, when you've missed the last train, when life is just threatening to drive you insane, when your coffee's too cool and your soda's too warm, when the forecast said fine, but you're out in a storm, when you park for 5 minutes in a neighbor's bay and return to discover you've been towed away. When the jeans that you bought in hope or in haste are tight on your hips and won't reach around your waist. But my darling, my sweetheart, my dear, please don't fear or ever feel blue. From the bottom of my heart, I shall be there for you.
Thank you, Anna. Now Sean's childhood friend, Evan Nelson, will read The Beauty of Love.
The question can be asked, is there anything more beautiful than a young couple with pure hearts, clasping hands, in the path of marriage? Can there be anything more beautiful than young love? And the answer is given, yes, there is a more beautiful thing. It is the sight of an old man and an old woman finishing their journey together on that path. Their hands are weakened, but still clasped. Their faces are worn, but still radiant. Their hearts are physically tired, but still strong with love and devotion. Yes, there is a more beautiful thing than young love, eternal love that has stood the test of time.
Thank you, Evan. Wonderful. There are no vows more meaningful than those which will be shared here today. Earlier, Sean and Juliana had the opportunity to share privately what their love means to one another. And I heard that there may have been tearshed. Sean and Juliana, as you go through life together, nurture each other in love that gives you room to grow. Always keep your partner in your heart and let every decision be influenced by that placement. I now ask you to turn and face one another and join hands as you express your vows. Sean, Will you please repeat this vow to Juliana, saying after me, I, Sean, take you, Juliana, to be my wife.
I, Sean, take you, Juliana, to be my wife.
I promise to love, honor, and trust you in sickness and in health.
I promise to love, honor, and trust you in sickness and in health.
I vow to be true and loyal to you for as long as we both shall live.
I vow to be true and loyal to you for as long as we both shall live.
Through adversity and prosperity, I will love you all the days of my life.
Through adversity and prosperity, I will love you all the days of my life.
Juliana, will you please repeat this vow to Sean, saying after me, I, Juliana, take you, Sean, to be my husband.
I, Juliana, take you, Sean, to be my husband.
I promise to love, honor, and trust you in sickness and in health.
I promise to love, honor, and trust you in sickness and in health.
I vow to be true and loyal to you for as long as we both shall live.
I promise to be true and loyal to you for as long as we both shall live.
Through adversity and prosperity, I will love you all the days of my life.
Through adversity and prosperity, I promise to love you all the days of our lives.
Sean and Juliana will now exchange rings as a symbol of their love and commitment to each other. These rings will be a reminder of the vows that you have given and your eternal love. Sean, please place the ring on Juliana's left hand. Juliana, please place the ring on Sean's left hand. Juliana and Sean, you have expressed your desire to join together in marriage. You have shown your love and affection for one another time and time again over the last 6 years and here today with these vows. I have one final question for each of you. Do you, Sean, take Juliana to be your lawfully wedded wife? If so, say I do.
I do.
And do you, Juliana, take Sean to be your lawfully wedded husband? If so, say I do.
I do.
And by the authority given to me by the American Marriage Ministries, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss. Now presenting Sean and Juliana Brosier.
Thank you. know my family from California. Thank you guys so much for making it. Thank you. It really means a lot. You guys have just come to our point. Some people from the beginning of our lives, when we were born, some people later, but each of these relationships we really value, and you guys mean so much. Or you wouldn't be here today. So
but they're going to give it a go now, and we'll see what happens.
So you guys stole our welcome thunder. Thank you for welcoming everybody. But hey, we did say one thing. We got many generations covered here in our family. So I want to do a shout out for great aunt Kathy. Yay! Juliana's great aunt. We got Sean's grandmother coming in. And we got two babies here, one of which is Cyrus, Sean and Juliana's nephew. And there's a second baby somewhere around here. Yeah, Rocco. Sorry about that, I did not sign that out. Okay. So, I'll try to get through this without crying. We have the unenviable task of talking about Juliana in 2 minutes or less. So we thought long and hard, and there's really two qualities that come to mind when we talk about Juliana, amongst many other great ones. First of all, if you know her, you know this is true. She's an incredibly focused and determined individual. That's one. And if you keep this up, I will talk all night. I got no problem with that. And ever since she was a baby, chasing her own brother and sister, she was always determined. Elementary school, this ball reminds me of this one all the time, she had a personal goal of not missing a day of school. She did after 3 years, which was a school record in elementary school. On into high school, where she excelled at academics, sports, she was class president for a couple years, and then on to great things at Ohio State University. And then as well at Procter & Gamble. So, very focused, very determined. The second characteristic that often does not go hand in hand with the first is she has tremendous empathy. She's an incredibly compassionate person. She cares, she got that from her mom, to be clear. She cares so much. She gives back all the time. The two of them do Habitat for Humanity every single month. Feeding the homeless, care packages, and she cares for the environment. Cleaning up the Ohio River, which you guys had a good day on the river the other day. It wasn't so dirty, but it can't get dirty, so. So you put those two qualities together, and she has become just a wonderful young woman that we could not be more proud of. We are so blessed to be your parents, Juliana. Thank you. Which takes us to Sean. Sean is an intelligent young man. If you ever talk with him, you know that. Juliana once told Kathleen and myself that she would only marry someone as smart, if not smarter than she. She found that in Sean. Now let the two of them duke it out on which one is smarter. But in terms of his intelligence, he's got another great quality of the same magnitude. He's equally compassionate and caring. The two of them together have so many of the same shared beliefs that it's no surprise they found each other and have such great love for each other. They also love travel, they love adventure, they love spending time together. If you ever have a chance to just watch them quietly and observe, you can see they really enjoy each other. Supple dance. they truly love each other. So, Sean, welcome to our family. Eric, Cheryl, Derek, Ashley, welcome to our family. And I would be remiss if I didn't add, if there's any little Brenton hands that come out of this union, the sooner the better, I would be more than happy. No pressure. So Kathleen and I were at a wedding recently. I told you, I keep going, Kelly. So Kathy and I were at a wedding recently, and it was Derek and Ashley's, in fact. And we sat across from a gentleman who's actually here tonight. And you told me, and I agree, that weddings are for young people. And they are for young people. They're big parties, they're festivals, there's lots of drinking, so you guys can keep up with any of them. There's dancing, and I hope our night is exactly like that tonight. But I disagree with you. Because weddings are for everybody, for every generation. Because at the core, they're about love. And in my opinion, there's not enough love in this world. There's not enough love in this country. And as I look at the two of you guys, you're overflowing with love. And as I look at this wonderful group in front of us, their love for you is so evident. So Juliana and Sean, we love you very much. I have a word of advice for you, because that's my job, as your dad. Remember this love, the love you have on this day. Nourish this love. Don't cry. Feed this love. Grow this love, because you're going to need it. You took the vows today. There's going to be good times. There's going to be bad times. There's going to be hard times. There's going to be easy times. And there's got a lot of in-between times. And that love is what you're going to be resting your future on. It is your bedrock. So always remember it. Remember this day and grow from it, okay? And in the words of a band that our family truly loves,
I'm going to charm her, tell her whatever she wants to know, and then I'm going to say whatever I want. But she'll be okay with it, because I pretended like she was smart. Did I do confirmation class with Derek? Heck no. I left that to some other stars. But Sean, I did confirmation class with him because he accepted me. Pretended that he did. So again, Juliana, you are intelligent. You may pick up on this, but I'm giving you clues. Sean is a very stubborn, intelligent, loving, caregiving, great young man. And I thought, he can't have some dog woman with him. He will trounce her to pieces. And he needs to find, and he tried some folks out. And I was just like, this is not gonna work. Sean can't be in charge of everything. Because then he'll think he's godlike. He needs a smart young woman. And I heard from you just recently that she's smart. So I kind of picked up on it a little bit. I won't talk about Sean as I'll cry. So Juliana has brought an incredible light to our lives. And one of the greatest things about Juliana is that she just melts right into whatever family she's with. And she has a heart of gold that matches Sean's. So like Daryl said, without crying, they're a great match. And fantastically enough, while we all survived puberty with Derek and Sean, which, by the way, was not a heck of a lot of fun, they have been best friends since. And what a joy that they decided to marry young women who also are great friends. So Eric and I are extremely blessed to welcome Juliana to the family. She has felt like she's been part of the family for several years now. But we welcomed Ashley earlier this year, Juliana this year. It's been a fantastic year for the Brandon Camps. But we love you both. We welcome you. We don't like your dad. Your mom, she's sparkly and pretty good. Karen, would you like to say a word?
Well, thank you everybody for being here. Really appreciate that we can celebrate this wonderful day with you. And I'm so glad that they found each other. And I just love them very much. And thank you. We're very blessed to bring Juliana into our family.
To get over the nerves, but apparently it's four, so please hit the bar right after this. I just want to say, first of all, thank you all for being here today to celebrate the love between Sean and Juliana. First sentence, crushed it. For those of you who don't know, I am Juliana's sister, Elise, although I'm sure, you know, as many of you have pointed out, if you literally just look at our face, you can tell. The disagree genes are goddamn strong. Crazy. So I've been with Juliana since her day one. I remember bringing her yellow flowers in the hospital to celebrate the arrival of my new best friend. And growing up, that's exactly what we were. We were best friends. Juliana was my favorite playmate, from Polly Pocket and Dress Up to riding flying turtles in our unfinished basement. And if you do not know what a flying turtle is, please Google it. And then if you start feeling jealous, it's a natural feeling because Juliana and I had a great childhood. Juliana always put up with me as her older sister. I mean, someone had to be the Ken for my Barbie. But we grew up together, learned together, fought off neighborhood boys together.
And now I'm honored to be standing up here with you together. I remember when Juliana started taking an interest in Sean, who was just a guy who worked with her at camp. Then he was the cute guy who worked with her at camp. And then he was the cute guy who worked with her at camp, who was also texting her constantly and making her smile and showing her how gentle, kind, and loving a man can be. Now, 6 years later, how wonderful is it to see a marriage begin for two former Camp Kern counselors? Juliana, I am grateful to have grown up with you, and thank you to our parents for my built-in best friend. I am so happy that you are so happy, and I love you very, very much. So, if everybody could raise their glasses, hopefully it's at least your third cocktail. And I'd love to give a cheers to finding the Ken for your Barbie.
Ladies and gentlemen, three is rookie numbers, rookie seven over here. Anyway, I'm going to do my absolute best to read everything that I wrote. And I'm not going to ad-lib. We're just going to go with what's on the paper. I assure you, this is light, this is breezy, and I will cry. Hello. We did this little dance before, but my name's Derek, and I'm Sean's brother. Unfortunately for me, Sean gave a wonderful, endearing, sweet speech at my wedding earlier this summer. And now I am here today to disappoint each and every one of you. For those that don't know, Sean and I have always been pretty close. We're a year and 5 days apart, not twins, as I used to tell unsuspecting people wherever I could find them, including neighborhood Applebee's. We had some rough years in middle school, my mother alluded to it earlier, which I'm now comfortable admitting, completely my fault. Sean is a kind and loving person. He literally always has been. I have not. I seem to vaguely recall punching Sean square in the chest. I seem to remember it being very justified, and I bravely ran to the back of the room. I also remember turning around and seeing a TV remote bury itself in the wall behind me. Sean's got a great arm, for anyone wondering. Sorry, Mom and Dad. I would describe that as not a high point in our relationship. I have to keep finding myself in this beach. We got closer through high school, through middle school, through college, and now into adulthood. Though again, I think my mother will protest at how often Sean and I talk on the phone versus how often we talk with our mom on the phone. It's a shocking number. Sorry, Mom. Anyway, Sean and I have always been pretty close. Juliana, on the other hand, I met back in 2018, the same summer she met my brother. If you haven't ever seen Sean and Juliana work with kids, work with young people, work with anyone ever, it's incredible. I can truly testify that it's some of the most exceptional works of mentorship and leadership that I've ever seen. And while Juliana is doing that great work, Sean is eating whole bananas. Peel, stem, the whole thing. His teeth turn black. It's foul. I've never seen anything like it, but that's what he does. That summer, the summer I met Juliana, I was on a leadership team with her. And we talked pretty regularly. We got to know each other really well. She seemed pretty great. Just exceptional, really kind, caring, hardworking person who really wanted to do well for these kids. And she was running programs that Sean and I had both run in the past, so we were deeply invested in her success. I wasn't surprised to hear that Sean was requesting to be on those programs. I was surprised. I was very surprised. On a night off, when Sean and I were driving home, and Sean's like, yeah, I've got a wild crush on this girl, Juliana. I really like her. I don't know if you haven't met Sean. Sean doesn't say things like that, ever. And so Sean, professing his love to me in the passenger seat of a car was pretty surprising. So you try not to scare him off. So you're like, oh, really? Like, is she nice? Like, do you like her? She's like, I like her. Like, and that leads us to the highlight of the story. It all came to a head for me, at least me, not them, when a woman in this room was wandering amongst a camp for children. But this adult woman was wandering around looking lost. That woman, Kathleen Disher, sitting right here. Yeah, yeah, you know, Kathleen. Kathleen, I approached this stranger, and I was like, hello, my name is Derek. I work here at YMCA Camp Curran. Can I help you find anything on this Thursday? Kathleen immediately said, oh, you're Derek. When is my daughter going to be asked out by your brother? It was the most shocked I've ever been in my life. I didn't know what to say. I still do not recall what happened in that conversation other than that opening. Well, Sean assured me when I asked him that, he's gonna ask Juliana out when the time is right. I'm not saying that Kathleen and I solely are responsible for their love and marriage, for this excellent party tonight, but the facts that I presented really prove that Kathleen and I are responsible for your evening. So, let's go us. For the crying part of the evening. In all seriousness, Ash and my wife wrote that kindly for me to put in all seriousness. I am so grateful that Sean finally worked up the courage to ask Juliana out. I cannot imagine my life without both of you in it. Sean, I'm so mad at this. Sean, you're the best brother anyone could have. Pause. I wake up every morning and I try to fill the shoes of the brother that you deserve. Woo! The two of you, moving on, are the best of us. You're the best of us. The most generous, kind, and goofy people that I know. I couldn't be happier that you found each other, and based on the last 5-6 years and the wonderful evening that we've all had, I think you'll agree. I love you both. I love you both. Finally, congratulations. And if everyone, at least some of you could say it with me, cheers! Cheers, baby! Woo! Thank you all so much!
Oh yeah, looking good, folks. Looking good. Sean and Juliana. And right now, you know, in talking with these two, I realized something that she realized, that there are several people that have the names, the first names start with the same letters, and it was pretty much a coincidence. So she told me this, and I was like, aha, and I realized something, that we got a little battle opportunity here on the dance floor. So right now, what we're gonna do is we're gonna call up everybody that has the first name starting with a D, and everybody that has the first name starting with a K. And I would like the D's to be right here. The D's to be right here by Daryl. And the K's to be right here. All right, you guys ready? You guys ready? Are the judges ready? Okay, okay. It's about to go down.
Here we go!
K-T, here we go!
We're the best, so you know!
We're the best, so you know!
this celebration, y'all.